don't know if I would call it sham, but it's no doubt that Medvedev is his handpicked successor, and I don't think there's any doubt who is still by far the most powerful and influential person in Russia. I don't know how you could. My understanding is he flew from Beijing to Russia to take personal control of the military operations there. I think that certainly indicates his position of power.
And you were talking about Russia before and Putin and Medvedev. As president, how would you deal with that government? Would you be engaging with Putin, Medvedev? Who would you? You said there's no question as to who's in charge there. Who would you treat as the head of state?
Well, I'm not saying that Medvedev is powerless. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that. I just think that it's every indication is that Putin maintains control. Most of the power in Russia, he picked his successor. I mean, that's not the first time in history that something like that's happened. I would be very upfront with him. I would be very straightforward. I would tell him that we expect better behavior from the Russians than what we're seeing today, where they, no matter what the provocation, are carrying out military operations in Georgia which exceed any reasonable activity that could any way be justified. And many things we have to do, I outlined them in a statement this morning. You can review that, obviously. Of course we have to deal with Russia and we deal with Putin, but it has to be on a very realistic basis and not one that there's any illusions about his ambitions. I think it's very clear that Russian ambitions are to restore the old Russian Empire, not the Soviet Union, but the Russian Empire, which means a near abroad, which means you have great influence or control over surrounding countries, Ukraine, Georgia, Azerbaijan, other countries in the region.